Hey, sweet lips, want to come with me?
What is she wearing?
Come on, love, I'm not going to hurt you.
We could
just be a little fun, yourself. That's all.
What is she wearing?
Just how many people have
Get
you slept with?
It's not rape if you enjoy it.
Just have everything you got.
Society tends to not just sort of put expectations on women. Society likes to create these binary oppositions, you know, male, female, black, white, night, day. And I think, you know, the expectations put on us, you know, align with those oppositions.
Well, see ya.
You're seriously not considering going out at night alone, dressed like that. Look at those heels.
Yeah, why?
You're asking to be raped in that, you do realise.
Bye.
Don't say I didn't warn you.
There's not a woman who has walked down the street who hasn't experienced slut shaming. You know, just the concept that someone has the right to shout at you, whatever, just when you're walking down the street minding your own business, that in itself is a form of slut shaming, because it's that automatic assumption that you're lesser, I have a right to shout my opinion at you.
Wasn't it? I really think it was horrific. It's frightening that such a violent and abhorrent crime can still occur in the 21st century.
It's kind of a little bit too horrible to put into words. When I heard about it, I just burst out crying and I was like, why am I feeling this way about someone on the other side of the world? I don't know her.
I believe the Indian woman was completely blameless. She obviously had a reason to be out after dark. She was travelling somewhere, and really, whether it's dark or daylight, it should make no difference to the safety of women in a public place. Women should be safe 24 hours a day, whether they're in their homes or on a bus or on the streets or in the workplace or at an entertainment venue. Women should feel confident about their safety wherever they are all the time.
No one was surprised, because it's just become normal. Women get raped all the time, and that's kind of the sad truth. We're not surprised when we hear about some woman in Frankston getting raped, or some pervert flashing a woman being dragged into the back of someone's car. It doesn't surprise us, which is just, it's sad that that's how society's become, that we're just not desensitized, but it's just become the norm. Like, it's kind of normal.
It's a horrific situation. You know, when someone gets raped in any circumstance, whether they be male or female, you know, there's obviously, you know, no good reason for it. There's no excuse. There's no circumstance that makes abuse a viable option, you know. So how someone can be asking for it, travelling on a bus at night, you know, these are entrenched cultural issues as well, you know. And it's funny, a lot of the Western media has taken this holier-than-thou stance, saying, oh, look at how badly they treat women in India, you know, when I don't think it's fair for the first world to pretend it has the monopoly on solving women's issues. The first world attitudes to women, you know, tend to make us an other, a lesser than a man, you know. So when the Western media gets on its high horse about how another culture treats women, it's just another way of normalising how our culture treats women, saying we're okay, we can be a culture of rape, we can be a rape culture because we're not gang raping women on buses.
If you're sexually assaulted, then there's going to be post-traumatic stress disorder, isn't there?
there's going to be all sorts of potential mental health issues and social interaction issues that are evoked from that. So if someone's bullied, it's just going to make those issues actually worse.
Is everything all right here?
Yeah.
Bullying as a result of sexual assault, I think, would be incredibly unhealthy for the victim and really detrimental to their physical and mental health. People blaming them because of the way they dressed or the way they spoke or something like that. So I think that that sort of experience would lead someone to blame themselves. And I also think if someone gets depressed, then they're more likely to have low self-esteem as a consequence of it. Or even if they're not depressed, I think anybody who has a sexual assault is going to have lower self-esteem as a consequence of it. And I think one of the symptoms of that is a self-deprecation and a propensity perhaps to blame themselves.
There are no grounds for anyone to be raped. They should not rape, obviously. But given that there are still threats to the safety of women, and I'm the mother of daughters, I would obviously like to think that young women do keep their safety at the forefront of their mind when they're out at night where others can't see and intervene to help them or be witness to bad behaviour by men. It's not about dressing or acting provocatively, it's about being aware of your own space. I'm a great believer in young women not being so drunk that they can't look after themselves or make an informed decision. Women need to stay in control of situations, and you can't if you're drunk or affected by drugs.
Yeah, that's the big question, you know. It's ridiculous, you know. Teach people not to rape as opposed to how to prevent being raped. You know, it seems like a bit of a no-brainer, but unfortunately it's not. How do you teach someone not to get raped? The only way a woman in this society can prevent her own rape is by being born with a penis. I remember as a teenager, there was one particular time when, yeah, I drank too much. I found myself, you know, being had sex with. I didn't choose to. I'd woken up, I was asleep, you know, I was passed out. But someone was having sex with me, you know, and I didn't feel like I had a right to say anything.
Walking down the street with $100 bills hanging out your pocket that anyone could very easily pin and take is similar to recognising the fact that if you want to dress provocatively, what are you provoking? The provocativeness is you're provoking sexual desires and thoughts in generally men. Now, if those men have a tendency to view pornography and, you know, they've got this warp sense in their mind and they see they're getting provoked, this woman could possibly cause trouble.
I think we've made women feel that they're responsible, that they were wearing the wrong clothes, that they were walking down the street at the wrong time of the night, that somehow it is their fault, that they did something to ask for this, that they looked at a man the wrong way, that, you know, they made some kind of gesture, something that suggested that it was okay. We've just normalized all these behaviors that are not normal, that are atrocious. Letting men think that it's okay to get away with this kind of thing is wrong, and letting a woman blame herself for something that's happened to her that's completely not her fault is also wrong. So I think we really need to change the way that we think and the way that we approach these issues in order to change this culture. Something in the way, yeah.